$6 for some shitty fries? Please. Chicken's ass clubs. Are you familiar?
A lot of questionable people around these parts.
Oh yeah.
We're in a questionable hotel without a doubt.
There's something you should know. What up? It's the Trooper. It's Monday. Made it to the strip a little bit early today. It's only 3:51 now. Bidding to find some food in a poker game. I have some ideas. Some pretty damn good ideas that I'm was running through clubs. In this one, out that one, no. In this one, rattle around, out that one. You know what I'm talking about, no? Flamingo action. I come out here to show you flamingos, and there ain't no damn flamingos to show you. Oh well, I guess you can look at some ducks and some turtles. Maybe a few koi. Why is the water so, like, super dark and murky? You can't even see the fish. As much as I was not necessarily a fan of the Flamingo Poker Room, that makes me sad. In fact, if it was still a poker room, I would sit down in there right now and play. Well, after food.
Let me steer you while you shoot. What's the essence in every lesson? When uphill is a blessing.
Appreciate it.
Hardest working man in Vegas right here. Got the Go Gamble hat, playing the Bally's tournaments. Hey, what else is there? What else is there to do?
What else is there? Have a
bam, there it is right there.
Have a sparkly pop.
Appreciate it, Trooper.
Thanks, man.
Keep up the hard work.
All right, I'm struggling to find food today. Can't find anything that I'm willing to eat. The food court downstairs at Bally's, nothing can possibly be good there. So I've been thinking about giving something a second chance. A first chance at Paris, a second chance, actually like a third chance. World Series of Poker's coming up. I know you guys are gonna wanna know. I'm gonna give it another chance just to be extra fair.
Broken or alone. not true. Not for me, not for you.
If I wanted fries, I would have gotten fries. I didn't want fries, but incidentally, they're $6. $6 for some shitty fries? Please. One thing they do have though, what? Cholula action. This is probably gonna do a world of wonder for the Bobby's Burger. All right, Bobby. I don't know why I would, because I'm sure you don't deserve it, but I, the trooper, and being extra fair to you to try this burger again. This burger should be about $6. It's 16 or something like that. 15 or 16? I know you're in a casino on the strip, but come on, man. Come on. All right, it's 14. Whatever. First of all, the bottom bun is soggy. Second of all, it's okay. This ain't no $14 burger. Whatever happened to Bobby's Burger Palace? Those burgers were delicious. All right, we got that coffee action going. Had a burger, meeting with clubs, sparkly pop drop. Now it's time to grab your nuts and let's go play poker.
Thanks, Trooper, for the sparkly pops.
Thank you, Lady Trooper.
Kids will love it.
Woo! There you go. Thanks a lot. We appreciate it. Howard and Nicole, what's up?
Thanks for the sparkly pops, Christina.
Yeah.
She loves it. It's her birthday, 44.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, girl. 44.
All right, so I don't know if you know who Flavor Flav is. You probably can't make him out because I'm too far away. And this is a prime lens, which means it does not zoom or any of that. It just stays at this angle the whole time. But Flavor Flav. What? Flavor Flav over there. Somehow you just can't mistake in Flavor Flav. When you see Flavor Flav, you know it's Flavor Flav. First of all, he does have the big clock hanging around his neck. Second of all, he does live in Vegas. I don't know if you know that. You may know that I moved to Vegas in 2014, but before that, I actually lived here for about a year and a half, from December 07 until April 09. And when I did live here, I worked at Carrabba's in Henderson. Flavor Flav came in for dinner one night. Before he arrived at the restaurant, the general manager had someone go to a booth and unscrew the light bulb over the booth because Flavor Flav didn't like the light. He didn't like the light, so the light bulb would be taken out so that when Flavor Flav arrived, his table would be ready. Flavor Flav, yeah boy. Am I right? I just cashed out from Bally's here. I lost $29. Wow. The car is entirely too loud and it has rainbow neon lights underneath it. What year is this, 1994? I have a question for you guys. I mean, maybe you guys can give some input, but it seems like every time I open Twitter, I see female poker players tweeting about the way they are treated in poker games and poker rooms. Now, I think you may know this about me, but I have played a pretty decent amount of poker. I mean, I play poker all the time. I play poker with men, women, and there are some adults that act like children, but I have played poker a lot. I have probably played poker with hundreds and hundreds of women throughout time, and I have never once seen a woman get talked down to or disrespected in any way or anything like that in a poker game, not in a casino. You know, I was talking to a couple of guys at the poker table tonight about this very subject, and they agree. They haven't seen it either. Every single time a woman sits down in the game, no matter her age, whether she be 21 or 81, they're treated with the same respect as everyone else in the game. I have just never, ever, ever seen it, all right? Now, when I speak, it is as if some people do not hear. Sometimes I think some people, you know, skip through the video and only hear a couple of things I say. Obviously, wow, is that wind blowing directly into the mic? I think we're okay, but I don't know. Obviously, there have been occasions on planet Earth in this century when a woman sits down at the poker table and some guy at the table is a complete jackass, talks to her like she's a child, mansplains. I think that's a really stupid term, because a lot of times people are accused of mansplaining when they're not really mansplaining, but I know what mansplaining is, so I'm sure that it's happened, okay? And maybe it's happened to the women who complain about it incessantly on Twitter. But tonight I read a tweet, and here's the other thing, like, I have been so tempted to reply to some of these tweets with my thoughts, but I have exercised some restraint because I know the shitstorm that will follow, and sometimes I just don't know if I'm in the mood for all that, but I'm gonna say it here because this is my platform. Someone on Twitter tonight, I read a tweet that said, Phil Hellmuth talked to so-and-so a certain way. Fine, Phil Hellmuth may have spoken to someone a certain way. I don't know. I didn't see it. I didn't hear it. I wasn't there. I don't glue my eyeballs to the screen every time there's some sort of poker stream with Phil Hellmuth or anybody else in it. I have no idea what Phil Hellmuth said, but it's Phil Hellmuth. Phil Hellmuth is subject to talk shit to anybody. Am I right? Back to the point. The tweet said, Phil Hellmuth, da 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 da. Now, and then it said, now imagine that you're a young, novice, female poker player just getting into the game, and every time you sit at the table, you get chastised and bullied and made fun of. Wait a minute, back it up. Pull the reins back. Every time? Every time? So you're telling me that there are girls out there that feel as though every single time they sit down at a poker table, they are chastised and bullied and made to feel out of place or unwelcome in a certain way? First of all, if you got money, you're welcome in a poker game. If Jeffrey Dahmer walks in the room, I know he's dead. If Jeffrey Dahmer walks in the room with a steak, not the kind of steak he ate off the ass of the one dude. No, not that kind of steak, all right? The money to play in the game that day, there's an open seat for him. What I'm basically saying here is, let's just come at it and swing for the fences and say that I think a lot of this is projection, and I think a lot of it is self-fulfilling. I think that there are a lot of girls who feel shy and timid about playing poker, and I think that there are girls who are afraid they're going to be flirted with. Listen, whatever your situation is, if you are this or that or the other thing, you should try to figure out a way to use it to your advantage at the poker table. But I think there are a lot of girls who feel that they're going to be treated a certain way. Then they sit down and they feel it, even though it's not real, it's like imagined or something like that, because I don't think that any female gets treated like badly every time she sits in the game, unless of course, every time she sits in the game, she starts acting like a total asshole and brings it on herself. Because there are assholes in the world who sit down at a poker table every day and bring it on themselves. And there's been occasion when I've been in a bad mood and I've been an asshole at the poker table. And you know what? I know who was the asshole that day. It was me. So I'm not even talking, I don't even think it's that. That's the only thing I can think of though. Maybe you guys can give me some input. Basically every single woman I've ever played with in a game, I literally have never seen anyone treated differently or badly because they were a woman in a poker game at all, ever. So I don't know, maybe it's just me. Maybe it's just me and the other two dudes at my table tonight who agree, who are like, yes, I've never seen it. If I'm at the table and a lady sits down and some guy is an asshole, I'm usually the first one to be an asshole to the asshole. And not out of chivalry, but just because I see injustice happening, but I don't see it. So, yo, that's gonna be the end of today's vlog. Touching on a controversial subject, if there's a shitstorm, is that wind? If there's a shitstorm, then let it storm. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. I'ma see you next time. And by the way, you know what? I don't like to tease. I'ma see you next time.